Afternoon, everyone. Did I wake you up? So we just got a few people coming in from the side, and then we'll close the doors and begin with the ceremony. First of all, I would like to welcome ladies and gentlemen to this ceremony, and allow me to introduce myself. My name is Mr. Curtis McDonald, and I have the pleasure and privilege of being your master of ceremonies for this afternoon's proceedings. On behalf of the staff and students, I would like to welcome all parents, family, and invited guests to the College Heights Secondary School valedictory ceremony for this afternoon for the year 2012. I would also like to acknowledge a couple guests that we have in the front as well. Joining us for this afternoon is also Mr. Brian Pepper, Superintendent of Schools, Ms. Lisa Carson, Assistant Superintendent, and Trustee Cheryl Warrington. So they're with us today, and we're in for a great afternoon. And you can't get a much better afternoon than today with the beautiful weather outside. The afternoon's program will begin with a procession of graduates, and we'll request that everyone remain seated during the entire proceeding to ensure that the audience has an opportunity to see this fine group of young people. The ladies will enter the hall through the far door on my left and the gentlemen on my right. They will proceed down the center aisle onto the stage. Before we bring this fine group forward, I really request that if you have a cell phone, that you just turn it off, okay? That would be excellent. So without any further ado, may I present you this afternoon the College Heights Secondary School graduating class of 2012.
Would you yell it from the rooftops down? get a good feeling, yeah. Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling.
This plan, pull me, grab me, grabs in the fuck you can't have me. I'll be the president one day, January 1st. Oh, you like that gossip, like you the one drinking what gossip.com. Now I got a word for your tongue, how many Rolling Stones you want? Yeah, I got a brand new spirit speaking and it's done. Woke up on the side of the bed like I won. Talk like the wind in my chest to that sun. G5 in the US to Taiwan. Now who can say that? I wanna play back. Mama knew I was a needle in a haystack. Upper body boy, plus made back. I got a feeling it's a rap, ASAP.
Oh. Sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. I get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, no, I get a good feeling, yeah. Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling.
The mountaintop, walk on water, I got power, feel so royal. 1 second, I'ma strike for you, diamond, platinum, no more for you. That adrenaline, never giving in, giving up's not an option, gotta get it in. Witness, I got the heart of 20 men, no fear, go to sleep in the lion's den. That glow, that spark, that crown, you're looking at the king of the jungle now. Stronger than ever, can't hold me down. 100 miles gunning from the pitcher's mouth. Straight gang face, it's gang day. See me running through the crowd full of melee. No trick plays, I'm Bill Gates. Take a genius to understand me.
Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. I get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, no, I get a good feeling, yeah. Get a good feeling, yeah.
A singer in a smoky room, the smell of wine.
Don't Stop Believing. That was a classic tune. Absolutely excellent. So before we proceed, I'm just going to ask the graduating class of 2012 just to stand, okay? Here we are, the graduating class of 2012. I can feel the energy in this room. I'm also going to call upon Lacey Lank to come forward. She's going to be singing the national anthem. Please stand and join the graduating class, please.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see the rise, the true north, strong and free. From far and wide, oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God, keep our land glorious and free. Oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Thank you, Lacey. Please be seated. At this time, I'd like to introduce to you my AMC. And you guys are probably wondering, what is the AMC? The AMC is my assistant master of ceremony. He's been selected by the graduating class to come forward. So please welcome Carson Toth.
Thank you. I am pleased and honored to be here today. Today I am proud to be part of this class of grade 12 students. There are 144 of us sitting nervously on this stage. We have a few special guests to bring greetings to us all. To begin, I am pleased to call upon our assistant superintendent, Ms. Lisa Carson, to say a few words to this class of 2012.
Good Good afternoon. I'd like to begin by acknowledging that we're on the traditional territory of the Clade Lake Tene. As a teacher, I was always proud to be included in graduation ceremonies, and you can absolutely feel the excitement of the graduates on stage, and you can feel the pride of the parents, the teachers, principals, vice principals that all sit here to recognize your achievement today. Oftentimes, these speeches involve talking about moving forward, a new path, starting a new direction, but at heart, I'm still an English teacher, so I decided it would be okay if I told you a story instead. Once upon a time, in a far-off land, there lived a wise old man. People would gather around him in the town square to ask him questions and to learn from his wisdom. The prince of the land grew jealous of the wise old man's popularity, and one day he told his aide that he had come up with a plan to discredit the wise old man. The prince would go down to the town square, holding a bird in his enclosed hand, and he would ask the wise old man whether what he held in his hand was alive or was it dead. If the wise old man said that it was alive, the prince would crush it and let it fall to the ground. If the wise old man said that it was dead, the prince would release it into the air to fly away. Either way, the wise old man would be discredited. The next day, the prince went to the town square, and amidst a crowd, he asked the wise old man, "That which I hold in my hand, is it alive or is it dead?" After pondering the question for a moment, the wise old man replied, "What you hold in your hand is what you make it. What you hold in your hands is your future. It will be what you make it, and I wish you success." Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Carson. Greetings also come from the Prince George School Trustee. I now call upon School Trustee Ms. Cheryl Warrington.
What a very impressive group you are. What an exciting day for each of you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, honored guests and graduates. It gives me great pleasure to bring greetings from the Board of Education, School District 57. Graduates, the journey to graduation has many challenges. You set your goals, you persevere. You can be very proud of your accomplishments. Today marks a major milestone in your lives. And this is also a very special day for your family, your friends, and your community. The Board of Education, School District 57, extends our appreciation and our thanks to your parents, to your families, your friends, and to the people in your life who have supported and encouraged you throughout the years. Also, on behalf of the Board of Education, I want to acknowledge and thank each of your teachers, your administrators, and all the staff of College Heights Secondary for their dedication and caring support in helping to prepare you to reach your goals. We proudly celebrate this day with you. It is with great pleasure that I congratulate each of you on a job well done, and wherever your journey takes you, wish you all the very best in the years ahead. May your reach always exceed your grasp. May you go confidently in the direction of your goals. And may you make every experience an opportunity. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating these fine young men and women.
Thank you, Mrs. Warrington. Greetings also come from the Parent Advisory Council. I now call Ariadne Hiller, who will bring greetings as a parent and address class on behalf of all the CHSS staff. Would Ms. Hiller please come forward?
Thank you, Tom. First of all, I want to say, I would like to tell you that English is my third language, so bear with me in this one. Good afternoon, representative of School District 57, administrators of College Heights Secondary, teachers, parents, families, and friends, dear graduates. It is an honor for me to be here before you on behalf of the Parent Advisory Council. Today, we celebrate this special moment with great joy, good wishes, and for the future and hope. Today's accomplishments are the result of a very successful team represented by the parents, the teachers, and you, graduate students. Congratulations, parents of this graduating class. Today, we celebrate the hard efforts that you have put day to day towards your child's high school graduation. It's not been easy. Some days are more easy than other ones, but as I call to my kids, the constant nagging of every day, let's go, let's do it, you did your homework, take your lunch, you know, is here being very well represented today. Also, I would like to congratulate the teachers, staff, and administrators of College Heights Secondary for being able to have the students as the center of their focus and efforts, as they were not able to become a solid working team this school year due to the teacher's job action. It's been a difficult year for both sides, but we can say that at College Heights Secondary, business was as usual. And what we noticed was that the communication was still coming in and things, for some reason, thank you, Mrs. McKay and all the teachers, it came together. We would like to thank the teachers for your support. It's our hope that all these issues will be solved promptly. And also we acknowledge that our teachers are the backbone of every school. Graduating class of 2012, our hope for you is that you find and follow your passion, because this is where you will find fulfillment and happiness. Today, you celebrate the successful culmination of a period of time where hard work, sacrifice, and commitments were the driving forces. Well done, graduates. I would like to finish this address with the words of a visionary and innovator, responsible of creating the concepts of the most of the electronic gadgets we carry in our pockets of purses every day. That's Mr. Steve Jobs. And he said in an address 2005 at the Stanford University commencement the following: your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most importantly, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. All the best. Good luck to all of you, and thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Hiller. I'd just like to thank Mr. McDonald for having me up here and the class, and I'd like to thank my mom and my dad. Thank you.
Thank you, Carson. To the graduates, too, it's an exciting day, and it's also a great opportunity, since we're on this high and where there's lots of energy in the room, to ask for money. So make sure you do that. It works. As we move forward, an important tradition of the valedictory ceremony is the address. And speaking on behalf of all the graduates for College Heights Secondary School is Carly Whitwam. Please welcome Carly.
I've heard there are troubles of more than one kind. Some come from ahead and some come from behind. But I bought a big bat. I'm already, you see. Now my troubles, they're gonna have troubles with me. These words are from the great Dr. Seuss, a man dedicated to children and youth. One who knew that today, you are you. That is truer than true. There is no one alive who is youer than you. He understood that what we become is a direct result of what we were, which is why these last 5 years are something that I hope I never forget. From TSN turning points and big league moves to taking a lap and rethinking our lives, these are the moments that have shaped what we are to become. After all, you have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. You're on your own, you know what you know. You are the guy who'll decide where to go. The time that we've spent in this school, the hours that we've put in, the friends that we've made, they'll stick with us wherever we go. Not only have we learned chem, bio in English, math, unfortunately, we've learned life. We've lost friends, and we've definitely made them, determined some of our weaknesses and some of our strengths. To be honest, most of us probably still don't even have a clue about who we are, but hey, I think that's okay, because looking back, we're gonna see that it was all worth it. What we got this year was a little bit of insight into what the real world is gonna be like. Just enough insight to be scared and very humbled, but also excited and optimistic at the possibilities. Think about how you first felt when you stepped through those high school doors. It was probably a cocktail of terror and excitement all jumbled up with a bundle of nerves. Just like before, you'll feel that again, but hey, now you're prepared. You know what it's like. You'll get mixed up, of course, as you already know. You'll get mixed up with many strange birds as you go. Just be sure when you step with care and great tact, and remember that life's a great balancing act. These are uncertain times, but then again, what isn't? If things start happening, don't worry, don't stew. Just go right along, you'll start happening too. This group is a group bursting with talent. I look out and I see amazing actors, artists, scholars, musicians, mechanics, innovators, creators. I look out, I see amazing potential. Who knows what this young group will accomplish, what these minds are capable of, but after spending almost every day with these people for the last 5 years, I have a feeling great things will be done. We'll have a couple Zoolanders, maybe a Shaq or two, hopefully some Brennan and Dales, some Dumb and Dumbers to keep us entertained. I don't know a lot, but what I do know is that whatever happens, I cannot wait to hear about it. I'm glad we had the times together just to laugh and sing a song. Seems like we just got started, and now before you know it, the times we had together were gone. And as us students, it's not just each other that we're gonna miss. I don't think teacher is a word that can even come close to describing what these people do on a day-to-day basis. They're babysitters, they're ringleaders, and when necessary, they're drill sergeants. What our teachers have done is demonstrated to us what we do or maybe don't want to be like. They've given us perspective. Somehow, amazingly, they managed to teach us. And most impressively, I think, they possess the ability to imply our stupidity over and over again without ever actually stating it to our face. Teachers of College Heights Secondary, we salute you. We're definitely no easy bunch. I can only hope that we've provided you with the amount of entertainment that you've provided us over the years. We would be nowhere without you. Actually, looking at myself and majority of the grad class, I'd say that we'd be at home in bed sleeping without you. Thank you to our parents, our family. You've kept on loving us, even through all the dumb stuff, I mean, learning experiences that we've had. For obvious reasons, we wouldn't be here without you either. Thank you for being our chauffeurs, our cheerleaders, and also, when needed, our prison guards. Thank you for enabling us in our successes today and also our successes tomorrow. This is a world in which having each other is having everything. Our feats are your feats, our successes are yours. Friends, family, teachers, you've made us who we are. As the great Derek Zoolander once said, you gotta tame the beast before you can let it out of the cage. Well, congratulations, grad class of 2012. You're about to be released. Thank you.
Thank you, Carly. That was outstanding. The next part of our program, we're going to move into the presentation of certificates as well as awards, right? And at this point of the proceedings, we'll introduce each graduate to you individually, and Mrs. Faith McKay will present each student with a valedictory certificate. If a graduate is a recipient of a district, community, or college site secondary award, it will be presented to them at this time, right? And Mrs. Gilbert will be here to assist with that piece along with Mr. Petrovic. Okay, starting off first, in alpha order, the person that's going to start the program is Cody Daniel Adams. Azima Amen. Rita Hussein Akhtar. Also, Rita has been selected to receive two awards. This reflects her commitment to coursework and to her school, community involvement. Rita will be receiving one of the College Heights Secondary School PAC Awards and one of the College Heights Secondary Work Experience 12 Awards. In the fall, Rita plans to continue her education at UNBC in the area of sciences. Congratulations, Rita. Daniela Elizabeth Anderson. Gage Matthew Andrus. Samantha Chelsea Arsenal. Samantha is also receiving awards. Samantha has been chosen to receive one of the College Heights Secondary School Work Experience 12 Awards. This intelligent, diligent, and talented student will be attending UNBC to study sciences. Samantha then hopes to further her studies in the field of medicine. We wish Samantha all the best in her post-secondary path. Azure D. Ash. Impreet Kaur Alec. Catherine Nicole Adon. Warren Reese Bashan. Matthew James Baxter. Andrea Marie Berry. Andrea is also going to be receiving award. Andrew has been selected to receive the Prince George District Teachers Association Scholarship. Andrew is well-rounded, who excels in the area of academics and dance. Andrea is planning on furthering her education at UNBC in the fall, where she'll complete her Bachelor of Arts with hopes of eventually moving into a career in teaching. We wish this hardworking and well-rounded student every success in the future. Kaylee Marie Bespoazzi. Natasha Sarah Binning. Brett Andrew Bobbier. Randy Ryan Bowen. Jeffrey James Boys. William Brody Brown. Devin George Reed Brown. Melisandra Bruschini Charmet. Shauna, actually Elizabeth Buchanan that walked off there, and this one here is basically Melisandra Bruschini Charmet. Brandon Henry Campbell. Brittany Patricia Carr. So it's the money can. Nate James Cassie. Joel Gary Shelifu. Cole Charles Chambers. Asen Thierry Chaudry. Asen is also receiving an award. Asen is one of the top academics. He has been awarded the UNBC Scholar Award and the UNBC Leadership Award. Congratulations as you continue your studies at UNBC. Deandra Marie Collister. Brittany Deanne Raylan Cooney McFall. Delaney Lauren Davies. Blade Ota Deegan. Matthew James George DeMore. Tanner Doughy. Tanner is also receiving award. Tanner has been chosen to receive the CUPE Local 3742 Membership Benefit Closed Bursary. Tanner is a well-rounded student who excels in the areas such as academics and sport. Tanner is planning on furthering his education at UNBC in the fall, where he hopes to complete his Bachelor of Science. Congratulations, Tanner. Madison May Dunn. Evan Robert Dykeman. Andrew Bradley Evans. Dallas Cora Eifert. Dallas is also receiving award. She's been selected to receive the Gladstone Elementary School Bursary. Throughout her time at College Heights, Dallas has displayed a consistent dedication to her academics. In the fall, Dallas plans to continue her studies in the area of English, and her ultimate goal is to seek a career in law. Well done, Dallas. Brianna Megan Foisey. No. That. Sorry, that's Duncan Victor Finch. Now bring on Brianna Megan Foisey. Kristen Grace Frindorf. Matthew A. Gasbichler, 7. The Ryan Plouffe Memorial Award goes to Matt. Ryan Plouffe was a student at College Heights Secondary School who was gifted in the trades. Ryan was tragically killed in a motorcycle crash weeks before his graduation. Matt truly represents the spirit of this award. Matt is planning to attend CNC to become a journeyman electrician. Matt was a career and technical center student at CNC and has already been in the trades for 1 year. Well done, Matt. Amber Mae Giesler. Akam Singh Gill. Leo Wilford Matthew Godin. Amy Chowey Gear. Megan Grace Gull. Tamara Ashley Gunderson. Colin Raymond Halseth. Colin's also receiving an award. Due to his dedication to scholastic achievement and his exemplary personal conduct, Colin has been awarded the Rotary Club of Prince George Scholarship, the College Heights Community Association Scholarship, and the Yellowhead Rogan Bridge Limited Scholarship. Colin's integrity has served him well, both in school and in the community. While maintaining an outstanding academic standing at College Heights, Colin has also been a member of the SALTS and leadership team. In the Prince George community, he has done extensive work as a volunteer with the College Heights Community Association and with the Two Rivers Art Gallery. Colin is a black belt in judo and is an active member of the Prince George Youth Soccer Association as a player and as an official. Congratulations, Colin, and all the best at UNBC. Christine Helen Hamilton. Samantha Marie Hamilton. Samantha is also receiving an award. Samantha will receive one of the College Heights Secondary School PAC Awards. Besides her outstanding academic achievements, Samantha is very involved in athletics, both in school and in the community. She has been a member of the College Heights basketball team and volleyball team while participating in such community programs such as hockey, ringette, and swimming. At College Heights Secondary School, Samantha has also been an active member of the leadership class and the yearbook club. Samantha plans to continue her studies in science at UNBC. Congratulations, Sam. Nolan James Hansen. Dylan Reed Hardy. Cassidy Marie Hartley. Cassidy's also receiving an award. Cassidy will receive the SEP of Canada Bill Hickey Local 603 Closed Bursary. Besides her strong academic achievement, Cassidy's poise and discipline is evident through her involvement in dance. Dancing since the age of six, Cassidy is an integral member of the Judy Russell's Dance Studio. Along with Cassidy's long-term commitment to dance, she is also a volunteer at the SPCA. Cassidy plans to attend CNC in the University Transfer Program this fall. Congratulations. Roxanne Kathleen Ivanoff. Victoria Patricia Kershaw. Taylor Lynn Kettles. Logan David Close. Cole Jonathan Kruger. Colton William Lambertus. Lacey Elizabeth Lank. Stephanie Nicole Lischke. Stephanie's also receiving an award. Congratulations to Steph on receiving the Malaspina Elementary School PAC Award. Steph is described by one of her employers as a responsible, driven, mature, and hardworking young lady who's been a role model to the staff. She's a dedicated student with a definite sense of community and civic duty. Steph's determination and hard work is demonstrated by her efforts as a Navy League and Sea Cadet. She has received numerous rewards and plans to train new cadets in September. These qualities will serve Stephanie well as she continues her studies at CNC. Congratulations. Nathan Robert Lee. Jordan Sebastian Lemoyne. Ashton Marconi Leon Terraz. Alana Merle Lewis. Alana is also receiving a reward. Alana will receive the Ryan Plouffe Memorial Scholarship. This award was established to the honor of the memory of Ryan Plouffe, a student at College Heights who tragically lost his life in May of 2005. Alana's hard work and dedication has contributed to her receiving the scholarship, which is awarded to the student who is pursuing a career in the trades. Best of luck, Alana. Jessica Jennifer Catherine Litson Parsons. Derek Ralph Locken. Kevin John Malgrim. Kevin's also receiving an award as well. Kevin will receive the Gladstone Elementary School Bursary. Kevin has maintained a strong academic standing throughout his time at College Heights Secondary School, consistently achieving principal's list standing. Outside of his academic achievements, Kevin is an accomplished archer, competing both regionally and provincially. He has also completed his coaching certificate and volunteers as a beginning coach with the Silver Tips Archery Club. Kevin plans to further his studies at UNBC. Best of luck, Kevin. Dominique Singh Manhas. Dominique also receives an award. Dominique will receive the Springboard to Success Scholarship. Besides his outstanding academic achievement, Dominic is an active volunteer in both his school and in his community. While maintaining principal's list and honor roll standing, Dominic has been a member of the College Sites basketball team since grade 8. He has also contributed to the basketball program as a coach. Within Prince George, Dominique has volunteered with the Heart and Stroke Foundation and with the Barracuda Swim Club. Dominique plans to attend UMBC. Congratulations, Dome. Joey Thomas Walter Mazzelli. Donald James MacArthur. Sebastian Vocal Menick. Joshua Mitty Marasa. Sarah Catherine Medcalf. Tanner Coleman Miller. Jasmine Courtney Marie Morgan. Brianne Murphy. Elizabeth Natalie Nellis. Elizabeth is also receiving an award. She's receiving the Prince George Teachers Association Scholarship and is also their major scholarship. Natalie has been a dedicated student who excels in our school band and drama programs. Natalie plans to attend UMBC, where she will pursue a career in teaching, a career well suited to her position and personality. We wish her every success. Jennifer Alice Noonan. Jennifer's also receiving an award. The Corporal Darren James Fitzpatrick Memorial Bursary has been awarded to Jen. This intelligent, diligent, and talented student will be attending UMBC to study biochemistry. Jen then hopes to further her studies in the field of medicine. We wish Jen on her post-secondary path. All the best, Jen. Caitlin Marie Norn. Okay. Darian William Nusich. And two on the bottom of the page, Joel Douglas Nelson. Come on down. The man that can do 400 push-ups in a minute. And Cody Jonathan Christopher Nickerson. Natasha Amy Oki. Daniel Young Oh. Daniel's also receiving an award. Daniel is receiving the College Sites Elementary Parent Advisory Council Award. Besides being a solid academic student, Daniel is a gifted musician. Daniel plays cello, piano, and violin. Daniel also has a black belt in Taekwondo and is a reliable volunteer at the hospital. We wish Daniel all the best as he moves on to study at UMBC. Well done. Christopher James Oliver. Chris is the recipient of the Bob Howard Memorial Scholarship. Chris has been an active contributor to her school. He has been an exchange student in Sweden. He has been a leader and debater. Chris is a wonderful tutor who has contributed to the academic success of several of our younger students at the school. Chris plans to attend UNBC to pursue a teaching career. Well done. Austin Gregory O'Neill. Austin has received the $1,000 per semester at the Grand Prairie Regional College for volleyball. That's outstanding. Congratulations and good luck. Dakota Osi. Stephen Page. Jarrett Roderick Parker. Jordan Matthew Patterson. Jocelyn Peacock. Hayden Allen Peterson. Jordan Anthony Picton. Matt Robert Prevo. Stephanie Melissa Push. Stephanie's also receiving an award. The L.A. Grace Memorial Bursary and the Rotary Club of Prince George Scholarship has been awarded to Stephanie. Stephanie is a strong student with a demanding course load. On top of this, she has completed an English class at CNC already. Stephanie is a volunteer with the SPCA. Stephanie plans to pursue a pharmacy degree at the University of Alberta. Well done, Steph. Kylie Ray Ransom. Kylie is also receiving an award. Kylie is receiving the Knights of Columbus Council 5246 Closed Scholarship. Kylie will be pursuing a nursing career at CNC. Kylie is gifted in the arts and excels at dance and art. Kylie has also been a soccer player and has volunteered in our community. Well done, Kylie. Brett Richard Raskob. Carson Richard Roche. Tanner John Rostrom. Jason Alexander Wachelski. Samantha Kathleen Ruth. Tyson Frank Ryan. Courtney Raina Reiser. Michaela Tarek Samsonoff. Priscilla J. Sandu. Brandon Cody Sass. Jen Alexandra Taya Shonky. Connor Robert Schultz. Nolan Carl Schwab. Nolan's also receiving an award. Nolan has been awarded the Integris Credit Union and the Gordon Ballantyne Memorial Scholarship. Nolan is one of the top academic students, both in arts and sciences. Nolan was also a key player on her basketball and volleyball teams. Nolan is truly a well-rounded student who excels in whatever he takes on. Nolan plans to attend University in Ontario in September. Well done, Nolan. Adil Shenawaz. Rafe Shizad. Cassidy Lane Shivera. Domenico Francesco Sia. Domenico is also receiving an award. The Rotary Club of Prince George and the Sam Leverman Memorial Scholarships are awarded to Dome. He has also won the University Hospital of Northern BC Medical Staff Scholarship. Dome has had a positive impact on her school as a strong role model. Besides being a strong academic student, Dome is a great lacrosse player. Dome plans to study sciences at UMBC in September. Dome, we wish you all the best. Yujeet Singh Sidhu. Lucas Herlambres Solius. Felina Marie Spetcher. Nicole Elizabeth Louise Spendiff. Nicole is also receiving an award. Nicole is receiving the Southridge Elementary Parent Advisory Award. Nicole plays basketball and soccer and is a member of the track team. She's a junior volunteer at the hospital. Nicole plans to attend UMBC to pursue a health-related career. Well done. Angela Brianne Spletzer. Nola Jean Stasiak. Nola's also getting an award. Nola has been awarded the Thun Family Bursary. Sports and Nola are inseparable. She plays soccer, lacrosse, basketball, and volleyball. If that's not enough, she also coached the grade 8 girls basketball team. Nola has also been accepted into the University of Alberta, where she plans to study kinesiology and then go on to physiotherapy. Well done, Nola. Keo Sugano. Ariana Tartera. Trendon Walter Tomasino. Yeah. Carson Ruckner Toth. Carson's also receiving an award. Congratulations to Carson on receiving one of the College Heights Work Experience 12 awards. Carson has completed two work experiences which required a commitment throughout the entire school year. The first was the Junior Initial Attack Program, where he trained to be a forest firefighter, and the second was at the City Firefighting Program, where he worked with a shift crew. Each work experience required more than 100 hours to complete. Well done, Carson. Connor Magnus Vigne. Matthew Gordon Wall. Matthew Jacob Warner. Connor Lance Watson. Jen Michelle Whalen. Tanner Monroe Wheeler. Tasha Maxine White. Carly Ann Whitwam. Carly's also receiving an award. The School District 57 Recognition Award has been awarded to Carly. One of Carly's greatest contributions to her school relates to her school yearbook. As editor, Carly has spent countless hours producing this document. This well-liked student will be attending UMBC to study international business. Well done, Carly. Congratulations. Megan Georgianne Weeb. Kyler Ebert Wilkinson. Chelsea Fern Williams. Chelsea's also receiving an award. Chelsea is receiving the College Heights Secondary School Leadership Student Award. This reflects her commitment to her coursework and recognizes her incredible school spirit, as well as the devotion Chelsea has displayed to the school service at College Heights Secondary School. We wish you all the best in your future pursuits in dentistry at CNC. Well done. Kyle Brandon Wilson. Jessica Lynn Wilson. Jenna Elizabeth Lindsay Wiseman. Tyler Ethan Coxwood. Lucas Allen James Woodruff. Matthew Stephen Woodworth. And the last of the graduates, one of my favorites, Wayne Nicholas Wachowski. Okay, so that ends the presentation. We're just going to wait for a few of the graduates to get back to their seats. And at that time, we will provide a brief photo opportunity for people in the audience who would like to take a picture of the graduating class. So wait to Wayne to get back. Let's hustle along, Wayne. So if you want to snap some photos, you may do so.
Say a couple more minutes. A couple more. What's that?
Okay, just another minute, and we'll have everybody just to go back to their seats, and we'll continue with our program. So basically, you just finish it off, and then I will recessional, and that's it. Okay, if we can just again have everybody return back to their seats quickly, and we'll begin the next part of our program. Thank you so much. Okay, the next segment of our program I hand off to our leader, our principal of College Heights Secondary School, Mrs. Mackay. Please welcome her.
Thank you, and good evening, or good afternoon. Seems like we've been up here for a while, but it's still afternoon. We now have the presentations for our outstanding graduates of 2012. I would like to have the following two students please come forward, Ashin Chaudhry and Nolan Schwab. Ashin Chaudhry has been chosen as one of this year's College Heights Secondary Outstanding Graduates. In his time at College Heights Secondary, Ashin has demonstrated incredible balance in his achievements of debating, academics, leadership, and school community service. Due to his outstanding academic standing, Ashin has been selected as the College Heights Secondary UNBC Scholar. Congratulations. Throughout his time at College Heights, Ashin has been an important part of the leadership program and debating team. This young man is reliable, dependable, and has a quiet and diplomatic sense of humor. He has mastered speech delivery and has represented College Heights at district debating competitions numerous times. Ashin is a role model to our young students, tutoring math and coaching the College Heights junior debating team. Outside of school, he has taken numerous initiatives to enhance his growth and citizenship. He is a junior volunteer at the University Hospital of Northern BC and has accumulated over 200 community volunteer hours in the last 2 years. He is courteous, polite, and considerate to fellow students and teachers alike. He has a strong work ethic and an excellent interpersonal skills, which allow him to build relationships easily. We are very proud to present Ashin Chaudhry as one of our two outstanding graduates for 2012. Congratulations. I told him he had to stay there with Nolan, so Nolan's not all by himself. Nolan Schwab has been chosen as one of this year's College Heights Secondary School's outstanding graduates. In his time at College Heights, Nolan has shown himself to be a young man of excellent character, great academic ability, and strong athletic skill. Nolan is a natural leader in all areas of his life. His efforts are genuine. He strives to excel and assist where needed. While maintaining high academic standards, Nolan has also enjoyed a number of successes outside of the classroom. In sport, he proved to be an integral member of the College Heights senior volleyball, basketball, tennis, and soccer teams. As a team player and captain, he leads by example, always with the utmost of respect and sportsmanship. He would not ask anyone to do any more than he would expect of himself. He gives his all at all times, no matter the challenge. Throughout his time at College Heights, he has also volunteered his services officiating volleyball, organizing officials for volleyball leagues, and assisting and coaching at his past elementary school. Academically, Nolan is very strong. He has achieved honor roll and principal's list throughout his time at College Heights. Nolan has a thirst for learning. As expressed by one of his teachers, he wants to know, he wants to see, and he wants to understand. As a learner, Nolan is a role model for others. We are very proud to present Nolan Schwab as one of our two outstanding graduates for 2012. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ms. McKay. A tradition at our school is a gift from the graduation class to our school. I'd like to call upon Brittany Cooney McFall to make this presentation.
On behalf of the graduating class of 2012, we are pleased to present $1,000 to go towards replacing or building our academic trophy showcase.
At this point, we would also like to acknowledge two people who have done so much work to make this event happen today. And Brittany is going to give a presentation, please, to our grad sponsors, Mrs. Smith and Mrs. Gilbert. Please come forward.
At this time, I'm pleased to call again Mrs. Faith Mackay, who will give the principal's address to the class.
All right, you guys, behave. We're almost done.
I was going to suggest that perhaps, well, I guess it's too late now, but you could give me the vase before you give me all the rocks. But thank you very much. That was wonderful. Welcome, parents, families, staff, and honored guests to this wonderful ceremony. And of course, welcome the class of 2012. Every year, I sit and try to think about a theme for this speech that will actually have meaning and value. I know I'm at the end of a long afternoon, and that's a bit of a challenging spot on the program, but I don't mind. Every year, I try to think of a word that I can expand on to give insight, encouragement, and acknowledgement for what you have accomplished. So I sat down to write my speech this year, as I do, and I found myself, as I'm sure most of us who write speeches find themselves, randomly Googling for ideas. Then I checked a few emails, popped onto Facebook to see what my kids are up to, went back to writing, Googled some more, Skyped with my mom for a little bit, emailed myself a reminder, Googled again, went back to Facebook, saw some great pictures of penguins on my daughter's Facebook because she'd just been to the Calgary Zoo. Then I watched a YouTube on penguins, which was really interesting. And then my husband kind of popped his head in and said, "How's it going?" I said, "Just fine." He said, "Are you actually working on it?" I said, "Of course I am." And as he walked out, he said, "Because it looks more like you're just on Facebook." I said, "No, I'm not. I'm working." So back to writing my speech. And then I just kind of started to stare out the window at the garden for a bit. Suddenly it came to me. I had a realization. You know, when you suddenly sound yourself sounding like your parents, and the parents in the audience understand that, grads, you will someday. But you know when you find yourself saying, "Don't make me come up there," or "Because I said so." And then you say to yourself, "Wow, I sound just like my mother." Well, it was like that, only different. I suddenly realized I sounded just like my kids. I was procrastinating digital style. I was doing everything I could except write my speech, and I was doing it via digital media. And that's when the word came to me, the word that inspired this speech. Wait for it, Facebook. Do you know that Facebook was only 4 years old when you started high school? A child starting out on life, kind of like you guys are right now. And now Facebook is, well, Facebook. Then I started, because I love words, because I'm also an English teacher. Sorry, you've got two this afternoon, can't help it. I started to think about the actual words. Facebook's not only a verb, but a noun. You have a Facebook, and you can Facebook. And then I write Facebook on Microsoft Office, and I get a red squiggly line, and I write click it, and it capitalizes the word, and the red squiggly line goes away, like magic. And so we all know if Microsoft Word can correct it, it has to be real. So let's look at the actual words, face. Face has uses of expression, appearance, and identity amongst others. Okay, fair enough. As a verb, face can mean the following: to look towards or in the direction of, or confront courageously. Okay, the part about expression, appearance, and identity amongst others certainly applies. We'll use that part. And then we think of book. Book is a set of written, printed, illustrated, or blank sheets. A book produced in electronic format is known as an e-book. I can go with that. So I put it together. A device that uses expression, appearance, and identity amongst others in a set of written, printed, illustrated, or blank sheets produced in electronic format.
There we have Facebook. Okay, so I'm at this part of my speech. I'm thinking, where am I going to go now? But the whole thing brought me to the thought about Facebooking, Googling, Twittering, blogging, texting, Skyping, YouTubing, although that actually sounds like something you should do in water. All of this really made me think about the world that you live in. The world that your parents, your grandparents, and I make some attempt to scratch our existence in. I mean, it took me 10 minutes to figure out how to turn the page on my Kindle that I got for Mother's Day. And I'm not kidding you, it took me 10 minutes. I thought it was a touchscreen, but you had to push the button. It's an incredible world. Don't laugh, it's true. It's an incredible world. This world spans nationalities, religion, age, philosophies, language, borders. It can ignore gender, race, rich and poor. It can be tolerant, ignorant, compassionate, and cruel. It's like no other world we'd have ever seen, and it's your world. It creates language daily. Something can go viral, which until a few years ago meant something that you had to see the doctor for. Meaning can be shared with simple letters, although I never, and I mean never, will write LOL. And I still use capital letters and end punctuation in my BBMs. But that's because I'm an English teacher. But having said all of that, and thought about the digital world you live in, and having spent hours Googling inspirational quotes, I still come back to one simple thought. It doesn't matter how we communicate, it only matters that we do. Communication happens between many species. Written communication makes us human. I used to say to my students, when you write, you are simply taking a series of circles and lines that make up the alphabet to create a agreed-upon script through which another human being can read your mind. Pretty amazing. No other being can do this. When you write, another human being can read what is in your mind miles, continents, even centuries away. Lines and circles, thoughts, beliefs, truths, and yes, even lies. This is the power of language. This is the power of communication. This is the power of Facebook. But it doesn't matter if you tweet, blog, Facebook, YouTube, Google, text, email, BBM, or simply make lines and circles on a piece of paper. What matters is what you say. What matters, it matters what you communicate, it matters how you accept others, it matters how you treat others. It matters how you stay connected to those you love, it matters how you connect to those that you don't know. It matters what you say, not how you find a way to say it. So during my meandering through the net, as I procrastinated in the digital age, I found thousands upon thousands of quotes, thousands upon thousands of thoughts and ideas from thinkers from every country, religion, nationality, race, walk of life, and century. And I settled on three quotes that I wanted to share with you today. The first was not created digitally, nor did I first read it online, but now it is accessible, so feel free to look it up after. In the late 1500s, John Donne wrote, with circles and lines and paper, in his Meditation 17, that no man is an island entire of itself. Every man is a piece of the continent, a part of the main. If a clod be washed away by the sea, Europe is the less, as well as a promontory were, as if a manner of thy friends or of thy own were. Any man's death diminishes me, because I am involved in mankind. And therefore, never send to know for whom the bell tolls, it tolls for thee. The first time I read these words, it solidified in me my connection with humanity. Thoughts from centuries before my time transcended into my mind and becoming a part of who I was because of the written word. The second quote I found was a few years ago when I was Googling for a different grad speech. It's by John Assaraf, who said, "We are all connected. We just don't see it. There isn't an out there and an in here. Everything in the universe is connected. Everything is made up of exactly the same thing, whether it's your hand, the ocean, or a star." Again, circles and lines that make meaning of our existence. The final quote has undoubtedly been thought, spoken, written, and gone viral, and it was said by the Dalai Lama. Our prime purpose in this life is to help others, and if you can't help them, at least don't hurt them. Okay, and I have one last quote. It's not as significant as the rest, but I really like it. It's a quote by Bill Crosby. I know the audience will remember who he is. You guys probably don't have a clue, but that's okay. He said, "Humans are the only creatures that allow their young to come back home." So a cautionary word to parents, because today, don't be clicking your heels quite yet and thinking you'll be turning their rooms into an office or a sewing room, because they'll be back.
But I like this quote because it also highlights another unique characteristic of our young. We never stop caring for or worrying about our young, our children. So those are four small quotes among the thousands I found or could have quoted. And they came to me via the internet. And now I speak them and they intermingle with your thoughts. It's really amazing. But it's not the internet that does this. John Donne, the Dalai Lama, even Bill Crosby had these thoughts before the internet. And for many, many centuries, thoughts were passed and intermingled without the internet. We have always shared our thoughts because that is what makes us human. What I'm asking you to do today is think, is how to share your thoughts, is what you think. It's about how you say it, it's about what you say. So go ahead, type with your thumbs, but type about justice. Skype whenever you can, but Skype with your grandparents too. Or better yet, use that old-fashioned technology called face-to-face and have dinner with them. YouTube your accomplishments, but don't rely on that. We're not all Justin Biebers. Tweet your opinions, but make sure your opinions are tweet-worthy. BBM your thoughts, but never send a thought that you do not have the courage to say in person. Google information, but check the source. As Douglas Adams, the author of The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, said, "Don't believe anything you read on the net except this." Well, including this, I suppose. Read your Kindle, but read the classics. But most of all, remember your true face. It is who you are in both the real and virtual world. Remember your true book. It is the story of your life, your past, your now, and your future. And remember to use the lines and circles of your words to better your relationships, your thoughts, and your world. Go ahead and Facebook, but remember to use your powers for good, not evil. And spend time with those you love. And when you write your book, make sure you fill your book with lines and circles that represent your true self, help you stay connected to your true purpose, help you and others be tolerant and caring of those different from you, and help make the world a better place. And every now and then, I know you don't believe this, it's okay to shut it all off, to sit quietly by yourself, and procrastinate the old-fashioned way by staring out the window at a garden, using the most powerful and wonderfully created computer, wonderful computer ever created, your own mind. Congratulations and thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Mackay. I guess it leads us to almost the ending, so I would like to thank my assistant, Carson Toth, for contributing for this afternoon. It was a pleasure to have him assisting me, so thank you, Carson. I've been asked to remind the grads that all the gowns need to be returned to the coat check immediately after the ceremony or at the latest 4 p.m. And I must mention as well, outside in the foyer, we found a little silver bracelet. I think it's either an ankle bracelet or something. And in the washroom, we also found a pink cell phone. So if you're the owner of either of these, please come up and see us. It's at the table. I've also asked to mention that the dance here tonight is at 7 o'clock. The doors will be open just before 7, and the baby picture show begins at 9 p.m. This marks the end of the year 2012 valedictory ceremony. I would ask that you please remain in your seats until the graduates have left the auditorium. Thank you and good afternoon. Enjoy the evening. Be safe. Grads, will you please stand for the final time, ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class of 2012. You are wrong in all the right ways, on the underdog. Yeah.
my glass is empty. That sucks.
So if you're too school for cool,